uko yanesheje bitangaje ifarashi nuwihetse yabiroshye mu nyanja.
Ifarashi nuwihetse yabiroshye mu nyanja. God bless you, beloved brothers, in the name of Jesus Christ. It is a joy, it is a great joy to gathering together, even if we gather through internet, but it is the way God help us. Brother from Gisenyi, they already opened the temple. And the Chibuye Rubengera also they have opened. Praise God for that. Amen. Even us, in the coming days, we will have to be opened also. The first of all, in Kigali, the corona is going on reducing. Even if the people they are going open the churches one by one, and here in Kigali there are many temples, but you know that God has blessed and given us for that. God bless you. Amen. The servant of God, Nzamwita, is going to continue. Then on Sunday, we will follow Kreferde at 11 a.m. It is not no longer at 4 a.m. We are going to follow at 11 a.m. That is because of 1 hour. I cannot let us to do in a good way. Now we are going to follow at 11 a.m. Sunday. Then Saturday will be in 8:30 p.m. For that, be aware so that we not miss the food of that time. And I love to pray for the brother Frank Moa in his old age. God is going on, help him. God bless you. Let us pray. Father, Lord, living God, we praise your name this evening. Thank you, Father. Lord, you care to your people. Amen. I pray this evening, feed everyone, Lord. Continue to help your servant. These brothers and sisters, where they are in their homes, give the way that they can follow through their telephones so that they cannot miss the word of today. Lord, I pray, visit your children where they are. Maybe it is possible there are some others that don't have the job, but be aware and care for them. We pray for the widows, orphans, and even others, Lord. All of us, give us the spirit for prayers, and pray with all effort. When you pray with effort, that's the way of going with you and be with you. Thank you, Lord. Bless us in everything from starting to the end. In the name of Jesus Christ,
amen.
Amen. Amen. Let us receive the servant of God. Brothers and sisters, I first greet you in the name of Jesus Christ. I thank God because He protects us and allows us to reach this day, even in this evening. Thanks and glory be to our Lord. Amen. We are at the end time, or the end of the days. We are preparing to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. That's why the way you have the opportunity to remind one another according to our readiness and preparedness of his coming. I encourage it every time so that you can hear, you can listen his word. Because his word is the one who leads us. When you have the weakness and you go aside, you go afar from his word, that his word is the same that brings us back. The one we receive, there are some you heard, and maybe you forget because you are a human being, but word every time brings us in order every time. Thank God and praise Him. The aim of the coming together is to hear what God wants from us. Thank God and praise Him. And also hear His word. And His word is the life, is the eternal life. Thank God and praise Him. Because Paul said, those who have the flesh and blood only, meaning that those ones who don't have the word of God in them, they only have the blood and the flesh only, they will not inherit the kingdom of God. That's why every time you are encouraged to receive His word. Praise God and thank Him so that you can inherit the kingdom of God. God bless you. Let us wait to stand up where you are, so as the brother can end for us in the King, the first King. First King is chapter 17, verse 8 to 14. Verse 8 up to verse 14. Then the word of the Lord came to him, saying, "Rise, go to the Zarephath, which long to Sidon, and wait there. See, I have commanded the widow there to provide you." So he rose, went to Zarephath, and went. He came to get the city. Indeed, a widow was there gathering sticks. And he called her and said, "Please bring me a little water in the cup, and I may drink." As she was going, he get it. He called her, said, "Please bring me a morsel of the bread in your hand." So she said, "As the Lord, your God, lives, I do not have bread, only a handful of flour of bean and a little oil in a jug. And I see I am gathering a couple of sticks that I may go in and prepare it for myself and my son, that he may eat it and die." And Elijah said to her, "Do not fear. Go and sow as you have said, but make me a small cake from it first and bring it to me, and offered, make some for yourself and your son. For thus says the Lord God of the Israel, the bean of the furrow shall not be used cup, and nor shall the jug of oil run dry." First Timothy chapter 3. Own widows who are really widows, but if any widow has children or grandchildren, let them first learn to show pity at home and do repay their parents, for this is good and acceptable before God. Now she who is really a widow and left alone trusts in God and continues in supplication and prayers night and day. You can sit down. We are talking about concerning The councils, exhortation is of the apostles that was going on giving us in different ways. That's part you are going on remaining in this evening. As you always reminding, you continue to remind among us because it is our life. Praise God and thank Him. We are in the end time, as used to say it. We are at the end of the time. As used and you know, we know clearly, God has blessed us and sent to us the prophet Elijah. The prophet Elijah, the scriptures had said to us, and even the Lord Jesus said it, and the time of Elijah, there are many widows, but God never said to all of them, but He sent to one widow at Zarephath. Thank God and praise Him. It has meaning to us. All for the man of the giving food in that cup. You know that the food you have to care of is the bread of the word, is the word of God, and the word of God is the bread. Thank God and praise Him. And when He comes back, even the fresh way, in the time of Elijah, there are many widows. But God never sent to all of them in the many, but only sent to one widow at Zarephath. God, maybe it was possible to you in this time like this one. I know that we are also in the time of Elijah. God sent the prophet Elijah. As He planned it in His plan, so that He will send it prophet in the age, seventh age, at the age of the Laodicea, and it is also the end age, and that's where the flag of the that crossing as a group was raised. Thank God and praise Him. We are at the end. We are in the closing of the work. Mostly to us as nations, as Gentiles. Before God go back to Israel, God must first close with the Gentiles, His nations, as He promised it. And also He promised is the faithful. Amen. And we're in the time really that you have to be careful and to talk about according to the coming back of our Lord Jesus Christ. Because very soon to come. The coming of the Lord is very soon, is approaching us. That's how our hearts. He must always saying, Lord is coming. Lord is coming. Here there's a brother said, there's where he wrote, said, it's a brooch book saying that the Jesus Christ, there He was, is the same today and forever. There's somewhere I said here, Manata, it was the word the believers of the first assembly was uniting them. They was always ready that Jesus Christ is coming soon in their time. You see, it was in the beginning. Even in the first age, in the time of apostles, they were starting the work. They are always ready that the Lord is coming soon. And He said, also,
ngo kandi bari
and also was in the same heart. They are in the same heart. They are in the same. Even us, you should all have the same heart. To have a common heart, to have the common heart in the scriptures. And also, all of us waiting the coming back of our Lord Jesus Christ in the same spirit, even if in the different parts, in different works, in different temptations, in different battles, everyone in his position. That meaning that all of us might come in this common aim to put the word of God in actions. As you have been taught. Praise God and thank Him. And also there was in the common heart and one life that hope that was make them to be strong in the time of persecution they had. That's why even you, when in your heart you are saying the Lord is coming, I am going to be redeemed, I am going to take out from this world, it helps you to pass through temptations and you overcome. Because you know that in this world it is not where you will stay for longer. By the time for shifting, it is very soon. Now that word, they was always seeking that the Lord is coming. That word was helping them to pass in the hard situations they was passing through of persecutions. Praise God and thank Him. That's why we must always be ready. Every time, all believers, that believe the message of as the apostles preached, they must always be prepared that even a temptation can come, even the persecution may come. Because Paul wrote and said, we never given it to believe Jesus only, but we given also to be suffering for His sake. Praise God and thank Him. But what we thank God? God prepared many things good to us. Even if they realize the power that persecuting the bride, choosing the bride, doing such things, from that time, that's where the bride will be ready to be raptured.
Amen.
The singer said, the sufferings we pass through is the one that make us to be ready every time. Thank God and praise Him. The bad things that we see in this world makes people to be suffering, to lose hope. The bad things that you see here makes many to tremble their heart. But for us who believe the rapture, that bad things make us to be prepared, to be ready. You hear in the songs, there is some power also. There is power also. And you also they sing the word of God. You read clearly that you will see the scripture showing that when the singers are singing, they sing the commandments of the God. That's why, even when they are singing, the demon goes away. Because they are being saying the commandments of God, that word, that demons are fearing. They are singing and the demon goes away. And remember the Paul and the Sila when they was in the prison, they were singing the glory of God.
inzugi zirikinga.
The doors was opened.
Nukuvuga rero.
That means
nukuvuga ngo abaririmbyi.
The choir, the singers,
they
are singing the laws, the commandments of God. That's why even all the time, we have to pray for them and God may help them. Mostly the choir, in this time, we passed of the COVID-19. They also meet with a challenge, as also we meet with a challenge, and also we are in the same spirit. Even them, you have to pray for them also, so they may stay in that spirit. The spirit they was in worshiping God and saying the commandment of God and could chase the demons. That power, even if in the this situation of COVID-19, they may continue to be in that power even if they cannot come together. God may continue to bless them until it will give us the time to gathering together. Now we praise God together also. Praise God and thank Him. The bad things that we see in this world make others to lose hope. But for us who believe the rapture, for us, we say we are almost to rise up because the sign is being appearing in our presence. The pandemic diseases, the wars and earthquakes are being manifested openly. Now you have the value, as the prophet said, I the last prophet, the first Elijah, you know, Elijah has worked four times. The first one, it was Elijah Itishub. The second time, that power worked in Elisha. That was the second time. The third time, that power of Elijah worked in John Baptism, preparing the bride, preparing, was looking the bride of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, when he was going to come the first time, praise God and thank Him. Now in the last time, mostly for us nations, is the last phase, mostly for us, that first time, as the last one, and the last prophet God is sent to us. We have already received Him, and it is a great thing that you have more than others. Praise God and thank Him. That's why, brother and sister, don't joke with this message, with this word received, but you have to take it. You have to take it carefully. Amen. Praise God and thank Him. And receive it in a rejoiced heart. You receive this word and you be satisfied. Amen. There's a way to receive the word and you don't be satisfied. But you have to receive the word and be satisfied with it. That's why even today we are reminding and widows who are among us that the word of God they receive, they might hold it in their hearts and also be satisfied with it. Even if they meet with a problem, a challenge, without having the husband that can help them in the physical way. But there is a great husband who is Jesus Christ. That's the one they must put their trust and their hope. God bless you and may comfort you and protect you from spirits of different ways and protect you the sufferings and may believe the word of God. That window of the Seraphat. She believed the word and put in the actions.
byatumye mu gisekeke
he mocks her in her basket his cup
hataburamo ifu
may miss the flora
yo kuvuga umutsima
to make the bread
mu mperezo ye
in his cup may not miss the oil that's why even you when you continue to believe the word of God that word God may continue to go on revealing you day by day increasing the word of, in you. You receive the word and you believe it. God will continue to go on revealing you the word. When you are gathering and you receive the food of the word, now the word will strengthen you and protect you where you are. Amen. Thank God and praise Him. If you care for the children or your grandchildren, the scripture has told us you might teach them a good knowledge wise, not the knowledge of this world. For sure, the schools, it is there said, and it is also important because in this world, you have to educate, to be educated, you know, the knowledge of this world. But there is a knowledge from heaven that goes with you might educate children to obey their family. Also, and those who are caring, if you care the children who have the father or the mother, teach him or her that he must obey them and respect them and have to repay when he will be old, he will be mature. Praise God and thank Him. That one, that is the plan of the word of God. And you have to do it if you are a widow. So that you cannot ashamed the name of the Lord. Paul said, writing to Timothy, order them so that they cannot have any shame, any blame. That's why the church, in the church of God, they must be a widow who are faithful. Thank God and praise Him. Maybe you can say I am a poor. You see, no. You have to trust the word of God. Amen. Because there are some others who come after. Those who come before you, who meet with the problem you had, yet they have the faith and trust the word of God. Let us see another one whom Jesus gave you an example. Luke 21. Because Lord go on saying it. God cares the widows and orphans. He never cares the poverty. But what He cares is His word. He never cares see that you lost your husband. But He sees only the word you receive. Thank God and praise Him. Because in the time, be dead as a believer or not a believer. When he died as a believer, that's what will make when you stay in the word of God and the rapture comes, you will see him again. Because if he were believing the word of God, praise God and thank him. All of those God is the one who knows. And we are not a judges. But what we do is to show to demonstrate the word of God. No one to condemn. But the word of God is the one who can judge us. Thank God and praise Him. Read chapter 21. And he looked up and saw the rich putting their gift into the treasurer. And he saw also a certain poor widow putting in two mites. He said, truly I said to you that poor widow has put in more than all, for all of these out of their abundance have put in the offering for God, but she out her poverty put in all life food that she had.
That's why you should not go far from the word of God. And you say, when I am a window, no one who don't know it, even God knows that I am a window. But what God cares is the word you receive. That's why God wants that His word to stay in you. And you continue to do according to what the word of God tells you. We are going to see again in the scriptures. In the book of Timothy, we are trying to be hurry. In fact, Timothy chapter 5, verse 5 and 6. Verse 5, it has meaning to the windows. Even the verse 6 has the meaning also. That's why when the word of God comes, you have to choose the verse to pass. This verse saying like this, that destroy this, can I stay it? You have to take a decision and you say, when the word of God destroys this, I leave it and I care to the word of God. Thank God and praise Him. Now read it for us. Verse 6. That's where you ended. Now you want to start from there. Now you try to be hurry, but in a brief, we are going to say upon there, and you know that in everything is God who is going to help us. But she who lives in the pleasure is dead while she lives. Let me repeat it clearly. Verse 5. Now she who is really a window and rests alone trusts in God and continues to supplications and prayers night and day. But she who lives in pleasure is dead while she lives. Verse 5. The really a widow who left alone trusts in God and continues in supplications. That word supplication is, hear it clearly. Supplication, there is being humble. There is a way showing that you cannot do anything on yourself. Trust in God and continues in his supplications and his prayers. Supplications and prayers. Night and day. Meaning that the word of God, to being care for it every time. Then, and to pray whenever you are being read by, even in the way when you are going, you can go on praying. Even in your work, you can work when you are praying. Meaning that where you are, you have to continue to pray the day in the work you are doing. Maybe when this word is saying, you think that it is to come in the church and you spend the day and the night you stay in the church. No. It means that to always care to the word of God in your heart, and even the work you have to work. Paul said also, we have to work. Meaning that when you are in your work, your heart, your hope, you put in the word of God. But whatever you want to do, you compare the word of God. What you are talking with them, you go to the limit of the word of God, and you know the words to say. If the words want to take you far from the scriptures, you stop it in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, every time, You have to know whom you have to live with him. To know the friends you have to go with them. You have to know if a widow. You have to know what the kind of the men who visit you. You have to know them. To know how you can discern them every time. Everything. That word. When you have it in you. That's the one who gives you. To examine every spirit. You examine every spirit through the scriptures. Without scriptures, you cannot examine the spirits. But you discern the spirits by the word of God. That you have the difference with others. It's everything we examine, we discern it with the word of God. It is not by our knowledge, but everything that we meet with it, with the power of the enemy. There is the power of the enemy that can hide and modify themselves. And someone can come like in the form of the angel and be humble. Maybe can come in front of you and pray and do some things. But you have to test in the scriptures. Even if you pray, maybe can come and speak in tongues. Even if you speak in tongues, what kind of baptism you have? Even if you say in tongues, the way he is praying, you have to measure it with the word of God. When you believe the word of God, everything you measure, you examine with the word of God, and he give you to stop every spirit. Apart from that, if you have the word of God in you, the demon is fears you. Demon is fears you without saying anything. Because in you there is a true word. And you put in actions. The home where you are, where you stay, in your neighbors, where you work. You put the word and you carry the word. You put in actions. You wear proper clothes. You be careful to say the spread words. Don't say any words in any way. Don't be the speaking bad words where you are. Where you care the word of God, the demon is fears you. Even your home it will fear. Praise God and thank Him. That's the truth. That's why the people can say this window is a man, yet he a woman, because he have the long suffering. She never go with other men and enjoying the things of this time. Now they could say this woman is stronger. He care the children and they are already. And demons never come to her. Do you understand? And he never produce another children. And I think you understand. He never increase other children. This window is strong as a man. That means that it is that power of word of God. And word of God is the husband in you. Amen. Praise God and thank Him. It's because word of God is the husband in you. That's the truth. Praise God and thank Him. Verse 6 saying, but she who lives in pleasure, who is in pleasure, in short words, if you call to be a believer and baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, and you go contrary to the scriptures, that's the way of enjoying the pleasure, and you don't care the word of God, don't care the things God said, that's the way of being in pleasure, and you go the way you want. You go as saying bad words with leze, being leze in the work. Paul said when you continue, you don't read it all, but when you continue, Paul said it. Being someone who wants to move up and down only, don't want to work. You want to go begging in houses, begging in the men and the women, but you can beg more Well, you don't be careful. If you have the seed of God, you can beg more, and you have one time you will repay it. That's why you must be humble, and you allow to be led by word of God. Forgive me, it is not to intimidate you, it is to remind you the responsibilities. When God allows you to meet with that challenge, to meet with that problem, that same God has the power to protect you as He go on protecting others who become after before us. It is the God of the past time, and also the God of the current situation, and the God of the coming time. Praise God and thank Him. From here, verse 6, but she who lives in pleasure is died while she lives. Who is Brazil is died while she lives. To die life is to move without the word of God in you, to go the way you want, to go in sins, because the sin, that's the one who brings the death. Thank God and praise Him. That's why here, Paul said, who is the pleasure, and he never cared the word of God, he never cared on the prayers, he never cared to think on the word, he never cared to come together in the service of God, he never cared to hear the word of God, and he don't care to any, like the scripture said, he's died alive. But you have to stand alive when you are also the normal. Praise God and thank Him. You have to stand when you are alive in Jesus Christ. Thank God and praise Him. In verse 7, I want to be hurry. Verse 7, Paul said to Timothy, and these things command, command this, that they may be blameless. Do you hear the aim of the desire of Paul is good. Command them that they may be blameless. When? Soon the time when Jesus will come. But even where you stay, you should not have any blame. Because, who knows, they must be faithful. Thank God and praise Him. That's true. They have to be faithful. They don't be with bad words to speak any words they want, moving up and down in different ways. Their hope, they must stay on the one they believe, who is Jesus Christ. Paul also said, Timos, command them that they may be blameless. Verse 8. It is like saying to others. Verse 8 is compared to the 16. Verse 8. It is like verse 16. Verse 8 and also verse 16. Mm-hmm. But if anyone does not provide for his own and especially for those of his household, he has denied the faith and is worse than any believer. Verse 16. If any believing man or woman, his widows, let them leave them, and do not let the church be burdened, that it may relieve those who are dearly widows. Thank God and praise Him. Now verse 8, He's saying to others, about others, if when they believe word of God also, and they want also to work to God, they have also something to do. Paul said, if anyone who have the widows, help them so the church cannot be burdened, but they can have the way to support the real widows. Verse 8. But if anyone does not, provide for his own, be careful with this, that word. But if anyone does not provide for his own, don't send it to others. It regards to all of us. If a man, and you have your own family, you have to care, and you don't want to care for them, the way you can find something to feed them, and you don't put your heart to something that can make them to survive, and you don't care to them, but and your heart you take to other side, and they meet with the problems, yet you have the means. Now the word also, the word have the way it can punish you on your side. But that window, he never told her to care for them every time. The word have the way they told the windows on their side. They also for you as a man, they have the word told you on your side. Everyone, be the windows. To help the windows if they are their families or in other ways. That means if someone does not care their own family, the scripture says, but if anyone does not provide for his own, and especially for house of his household, he has denied the faith. He denied the word of God. That's why you cannot say. That's why you have the house, and you have also you have the someone to care. When you believe the word of God, you should not take your heart and you see and go aside when you don't care your own family. You fail to care for your own family. First, maybe you can help others outside the way you have the means, but mostly the one in your family, in your house, start from your house. Then after, the outside, the others, you help them after. Do good to all the way you have the means. But mostly those who are in the house of the God, mostly those who are in the house of the God, mostly in your house, especially in your house, especially in the house of God. Then after you go outside to others, that's the order of the word of God. That's how the scripture tells us. Mostly, especially in your house, in the house of God, which is the church of God. Then after others outside, because you have to help all of them and praise God and thank Him. Thank God and praise Him. That's why the verse 8 tells all of us who believe the word of God, men and women. Because you can be a woman, and even you, when you have the people to help in your house, maybe you can be a window, and you have the means, and you don't care the one you are caring, even you don't care your children as you have. That time, that word is regards you, is concerns to you also. Praise God and thank Him. You can be a window, and God bless you. Give you money, and you work, and you get money. That time, it requires you to care, to provide His own house. Then after you go in the house of God, then you continue in the outside. That's it true. Praise God and thank Him. That's it true. Without saying that I am a window, no. Even that word regards you. It depends how God gives you. The blessing is in that physical way. Praise God and thank Him. When you care the word of God, it is the one among that shows that Christ is in you, because Christ is the one who leads us in everything. Thank God and praise Him for that. And what I remind you, we never called it to rejoice people, but you called to rejoice to make Jesus Christ happy. We don't do good things so that to be accepted by people or to be glorified by people. But the Lord said, when you do like that, when you do in that way, and you do good things to be honored by the people, the Lord Jesus said, that time it is you are repaid, you not have anything in the heaven. That's what the scripture said. When your right hand do something, that's the left hand not know what the right hand do. Should not know what the right hand had did. Thank God and praise Him. That's why. Maybe you could have something to help the windows. And you pass it to the servants of God because they are the ones who know the windows who are in the church. Then after that time, they know that windows, the one will see in the shortly that they have some issues, different problems, or she is old, she cannot work. And other things, we are going to see it in a short time. That time, if you want to do something, it's not necessary to do it to that windows and to know you. You can do passing in a good way. You pass the pastor. You pass in the church. That is the way of passing it in the church. When you pass it, even if you give it to the deacons, that time you already given it to the pastor. Even the pastor receives every report from the church. In the church, no any report, no anything cannot be communicated to the pastor. The way it is done, the pastor must know it. That's why even that support, when you give it to the deacons, you give it to the pastor. Thank God and praise Him. He must know everything that is doing in the church, being simple in the hard things. Thank God and praise Him. That's why you have to pray for Him, for that responsibilities He had. That's true. Even if you're a preacher, even if you're a deacon, even if you're a singer, even if you have such a gift, you have to know that. You should not know everything in the church, but the pastor, everything is being done in the church, he must be communicated to it. That's true. Thank God and praise Him. Maybe some things cannot reach to him. Maybe that is cannot have any impact to church. But something can have impact to the church. You have to tell him. But nothing, no anything, no any advice can be done without knowing of the pastor. Even every support that can be given might be given when the pastor is knowing. That's God is God of order. It is not God of the confusion. That's true. Let's see. Verse 9. I am remaining with a few minutes, but God will help us. What's important, you have to say it. Praise God and thank Him. Here, Paul said to Timothy and saying, do not let a window under 60 years be written. Let not a window under 60 years old be written in this number. And not unless she has been the wife of one man. Except 60 years old, maybe you can ask to yourself, that's how it is. Now they will help me, they will close me, because I have 60 years. Now I have to go and write me and help me. But when you read clearly, in the language Paul used, no any window to be written except under 60 years old. Also, when you read, you continue to read, you will find that there is some conditions to be fulfilled according to what the believer must do. There are seven conditions to, even if she has 60 years, there is also some conditions she might be fulfilled according to the responsibilities of the believers. First of all, she has been the wife of one man. It is seven things. Christ has old, taken into the number. She must be. That's the conditions. There's a condition. They have obligations. They have something he might do. There's something he might be showed. There's the seeds. They have given the fruits and become a tree that was harvested the fruits. Amen. She might have bring the seeds according to the word of God. And the others can come and pick the fruits from her. She might have some life she has experienced first. Has been the wife of one man, well reported to good works. If she has brought up children, if she has lodged strangers, if she has washed the saints' feet, if she has lived the afflicted, if she has diligently followed every good works. It is almost seven obligations. That's true. And also, according to the being written, when you see, Paul said, no one, the language he used, that's important. The good thing to write, it's not to write by ink and pen, but in heart, to be considered in heart. That's what Paul said. You are the letters that can be read by everyone, not written by the ink. Praise God and thank Him. From there, I think you understand without wasting the time. It is not the way of writing, and you take a paper and a pen and write. It is not like that. Even if he writes, maybe he can write because he's a pastor and he said, someone, but it is not necessary to know that he has written you. If they are deacons, it is not necessary to know that they have read you, but it is always to care you in their heart. And they think that window, that our window, she has such a issues, such a problems. But if she has the one who to help her, don't let not be a burden to the church. Amen. If she has someone to help, all she have the means, maybe you can be a window, and you have that 60 years, and God has blessed you in physically, and you have the means, but you can help even other windows. It can happen that it. You can be old mom and dad, and you have the means, you can help other windows or orphans. That's possible. That's why in everything you have to lead by the Holy Spirit. That's why you are not the people of the letters, because the letter can kill, but the Spirit can give us life. In all things, the Holy Spirit is the one who lead the pastor and lead the servants and lead the deacons in every way of seeing what can be done in the church or what can be good more than other. Every time, the pastor, his aim, his objective is to do good things that can be good more than others. To be good more than how it is. To be good more good. To be prepared more. kwitonda kurushaho, to be careful more,
kwitwararika ijambo ry'Imana kurushaho,
to be respectful more with word of God, to be sacrifice more.
Ikintu cyagaragara neza,
something can appear good and can be good more than, that's the objective of the pastor and also the objective of the servants working with him, and it be the aim of the deaconess, and it goes down and it be the aim of every believers. That's it, true. Every time we have to struggle, to look, to desire to do something good more in the church of God, because the Lord is coming. We are in the time where our hearts must always be saying the Lord is coming. What we are doing, also again, You should not forget. You have to work with your hands so that we can have our food to eat, and also to have, we can go with good nature without begging outside here. But be careful and be suffering, long suffering. It is not to meet with challenges and temptation and you shout, but you meet with temptations and you pray. Be a window, be not a window. You have to meet with temptations instead of shouting, but you have to pray God and help you and support you. It does not mean that you cannot give the support to brother, but without making the noise, without shouting, be the humble and in the order, without being a burden to someone. Praise God and thank Him. But also be careful. You should not be an obstacle in front of anyone. Thank God and praise Him. Let us go quickly. Verse 10. Well reported for good works, she has brought up children, if she has lodged the strangers, if she has washed the saints' feet, if she has relieved the afflicted, if she was diligently followed, a very good works. She was encouraged to do good works. Now, you continue. Now you're going to read. Read all the parts because I'm trying to wind up. Continue in the way you raise your voice, because there's no any other explanation you're going to add. Start the verse where you are reaching and you continue up to verse 16. Up to verse 15. Now you read. But refuse young widows, for when they have begun to grow wanton against Christ, they desire to marry, having condemnation is because they have cast off their first face, and beside they learn to be idle, wandering around from house to house, and not only in idle, but also gospel and busy bodies, saying things which they are ought not. Therefore, I desire that the young widow marry, be a children, manage the house, giving no opportunity to the adversary to speak disparageable fool. For some have already turned aside after stand. Those ones, they are the one who go back and compare it to the verse 7. But who is pressure? Such ones, they are just in pressure. They said many things, they go house to house. All of those things, they can make the name of Jesus Christ to be a shame. Thank God and praise Him. That's why, even in the verse 9, saying in the, among all the ages, because the younger widow, where they don't care themselves in the word of God, where they don't want to be in the prayers and stay in the Lord and care for the word of God and be fear with the word of God, because of their younger age, the younger widows, they are younger can deceive them, can deceive them. That's how Paul said they can be married. Now, if she don't get someone to engage her, if you don't have someone to engage, you have Christ is your husband. Praise God and thank Him. Because the time you're going to enter, there will be no husband and wife. But where you're going to enter will be like angels. Thank God and praise Him. That's why. Even if you are younger and you have that problem, you must not put your hope to your husband. But Paul said, if there's anyone who engage you, you have to be married. But also he must be from the Christ, in the house of the Christ. You have to check carefully and you see that if he cares the word of God, you see if he is a believer, thank God and praise Him. Because you should not be married with any believer, but you have to be married with a believer. If he don't married you, if he not engage you, stay on Jesus Christ and he be everything to you. He will be your husband until... Praise God and thank Him. Anna is example to those who been a window when they are still early. He spent in the windows 2 years. Thank God and praise Him. That's why you pray God. And we believe that God will continue to protect our windows among us. And he will bless them. And all of us in the same spirit how to be prepared for the rapture when Jesus will come back to take His church. That's why Paul command them so that they should have any blameless, to be without a blame. It might start early. It is not to be blameless when Jesus will come, but you have to be blameless when Jesus Christ needs you to come. And when He will come, He will find you without any blameless. Thank God and praise Him. Command them so that they must have any blame. Now in the verse, let me say in this verse, verse 16, if any believing man or woman, do you understand that word? Go back to that. You can be a woman and God bless you in the physical way. Thank God and praise Him. You can be a man and God has blessed you. You have that means to support the widows or others, other poor. But there's also some time you may have that, you may not have that means. That time Paul said, no one who can give something he don't have, it is enough. Someone to give according to what he have. Because no one who can give according to what he don't have. Don't condemn yourself because you don't have something to give. But God is a just judge. Even if they say you and you don't help them, you don't do anything to them, but you serve to say God is the one who knows in my heart. Because God is the true judge. People can judge you, but God is the true judge, is the faithful judge. Thank Him and praise Him. That's when you are in your word, nothing can make you to fear. Be rich, be not having things, be stronger, be weak. Nothing can fear you, because everything you do according to the scriptures. Thank God and praise Him. If any believing man or a woman has windows, let them leave them. The aim is this, so that the church cannot be burdened. Verse 16, if any believing man or woman has windows, let them leave them and do not let the church be burdened, that he may leave those who are really widows. Thank God and praise him. So that when you help them, that time you help church, so that the church cannot be burdened and can have the way to help with the lead that can have the way to help that really widow, the one who have the that fruits, who had the one husband without moving in different men from one to another. He stayed in the word of God and is protected in the word, and she was married in one man and others as we had in the scriptures. All of those, God has blessed us and give us his word, the word of the evening word, so that you can walk in it. The all believers, they can be careful, the counsels and exhortations that apostles was going on giving. Thank God and praise him, because he bring us in the foundation of the apostles and the prophets. May God help us to walk in the counsels, in the different counsels that the apostles was giving, and that counsels was being written. Thank God and praise him. That's why you are not ashamed to say to you what the apostles taught us, so that we can imitate them. Amen. Praise God and thank him. That one, that's how it is. And whenever we are seeing this body, we remind one another. Today I can speak on it, tomorrow another one will come and speak on it, even you can repeat it another time, even the pastor can repeat it, and others, the way the Holy Spirit is going on working in his church, he go on giving what is necessary to the church. Praise God and thank him. We thank God for that. Thank God and praise him. He blessed us and called us in this hard time, in the end age of the Laodicea, the age how the Lord said, when you are not cold and you don't boil and you are warm, I'm going to vomit you. And thank God, he gave us the word, and that word is the fire. That's why we have to always to feed that fire, to feed on that fire, the fire of the word of God. Every time a church must be near to the fire of the word of God. You should not go near to the fire of the unbelievers and you take with them. You remember what happened with Peter. Peter go to the fire of the others and he come out to going with them. He came himself falling in the lie when he lied, because he got near to the fire of the others. But thank God he gave us the word, and the word of God is a fire. That's why this age, when it is warm, the believers, those who baptize in the name of Jesus Christ, and they are care the teachings of the apostles, they should not be cold, but they must always be fire. Thank God and praise him. Because the fire of the word, there is a song of poet used to sing, saying that the fire, let's see fire. Let the fire come in the church. See the fire with the word of God. Thank God and praise him. Now, this age, it is just warm. There is something I remind you. The Israel, after crossing Israel, reached abroad, that time, they ate the seeds, the seeds of there was kept, was stored of that country, and the wheat was. Do you think that crops was being stored? Because the believers, God revealed them the things of the Old Testament, and you don't confuse it, but he revealed us the sweetness of the things of the New Testament, the commandments, and how the believers was going since from Adam and Eve. That scriptures was going on given. It is the stored food. It is the stored food. That stored food. After crossing the in that land, they eat the fruits that was stored. Thank God and praise Him. Meaning that to be revealed, the things in the Old Testament. Now we no longer say that today is the Sabbath day, I cannot do anything. But we know that we know the true Sabbath. God worked in the 6 days. Now the 7 days, He rested. And from Adam up to Noah, because Noah died when the party sick. 2,000 years. Now the promise was given to Abraham. The promise started on his time. The one who the father of others from Adam to Noah, the past 2,000 compared to 2 days. That means that normally God destroyed the earth with the flood before 2,000 years because the people was exaggerated and God regretted what to make the man. But up to the days of the Noah, God prepared. The prophet died when God has already prepared another prophet. The prophet Noah died. God already prepared Abraham because Abraham is the one who should continue. Thank God and praise Him. That one. Up to Noah or Abraham, there is 2,000 years that compared with the second. From Abraham up to Jesus Christ, they also passed 2,000. That means it was the first day. That's why in the first day it was created the sun, meaning that they created the sun, that meaning Christ, and created the moon compared to the bride and the stars compared to the children of the God in many, among of one by one. Now from Christ to today, now it is 2,000 years. That means that we are on the sixth day. We are going to enter in the Sabbath day because 1 day to God is 1,000 years. But 1,000, it is like 1 day to God. Now you are going to enter in the Sabbath. That's why whoever have the knowledge count the number of that beast. Because his number is 6, 6, and 6. Meaning that there is a block, that animal cannot enter in the Sabbath. That's true. They ate food that was being stored. But the food, the crops of the who are stored cannot be nice when you don't have the fire to cook it. It requires fire, and to cook it and boil it. When it is cooked, it is very sweet. The stored food is very sweet when you have the nice fire to cook them. Now, those who don't have the fire, they cannot understand it. But for us, we have the fire of the Word, and God gave us revelation through the prophet of the time, and we reveal that we might come back to the foundation of the apostles. God bless you in the name of Jesus Christ.
But
I take your minutes, like 15 minutes, I take your 15 minutes compared when I started. It was not my aim, but all those things have to be patient to one another and forgive one another and in love. God bless you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Thank you, Lord of Glory. We thank you. You loved us in this time, in this last time. We think that it must be faithful to your word. You called us and you gave us your word. We pray that you can help us to walk in your word and you put in practice so that that word can give us eternal life. Give us continue to be careful to your word and the counsels of apostles you send to us so that that counsels can remind us how you could take ourselves and how you could walk every time we are still in this earth. Lord of mercy, help all believers, bless our pastor, bless all of the servants, bless the youth among us. What we want in this time, the enemy is using the youth, but even you want youth to use them. Take the hands, help them and protect them with the power of enemy. In the name of Jesus Christ, that power of the enemy can be defeated so that our youth can be good and alive in your word. Bless our widows and the orphans and the poor, all of them. They are watching you. So that whoever have any problem in a spiritual way, in a physical way, all of us are watching to you, so that you can be answer to us, because you are our Father, you are the creator of everything, and also the one who do everything to us, even if you have the weakness and you have low faith, but you are always faithful. Lord of grace, continue to help us. Brother Frank, continue to protect him and to help him in time he is reaching in, so that your word can continue to be preached and may continue to have the value to our lives. Lord of grace, continue to help us. We pray in the brief. I know that even the remaining, you are going to do for us, for your mercy and your love. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Shall go, ya mean, I'm a chino, Mubi da fi